Rhesus incompatibility, also known as Rh incompatibility or rhesus disease, is a medical condition that occurs when there is a mismatch in the blood type between a pregnant woman and her fetus regarding the Rh factor. The rhesus factor is a protein present on the surface of red blood cells. Individuals who have this protein are termed Rh positive, while those lacking it are Rh negative. The issue arises when Rh negative mother carries an Rh positive fetus. During pregnancy, there might be instances where the blood from the fetus, which contains Rh-positive red blood cells, crosses into the mother's bloodstream. This can happen during childbirth, miscarriage, abortion, or even prenatal testing. When this occurs, the mother's immune system recognizes the Rh-positive cells as foreign invaders and produces antibodies against them. This immune response is known as sensitization. While sensitization may not cause immediate harm to the first Rh-positive fetus, it can have severe consequences in subsequent pregnancies with Rh-positive fetuses. The antibodies produced by the mother can cross the placenta and attack the red blood cells of the Rh-positive fetus in future pregnancies. This can lead to hemolytic anemia, a condition where the red blood cells are destroyed faster than they can be replaced, resulting in severe complications for the fetus, including jaundice, anemia, and in extreme cases, heart failure, brain damage, or even death. The severity of Rh incompatibility largely depends on the amount of antibody production by the mother and the level of fetal red blood cell destruction. Diagnosing Rh incompatibility begins with obtaining the pregnant woman's medical history, including her blood type to determine if she is Rh positive or Rh negative, which can highlight potential Rh incompatibility issues. Knowing the father's blood type is important, especially if he is Rh positive, as it helps determine the likelihood of the fetus being Rh positive, which can contribute to Rh incompatibility. If the mother is Rh negative, an indirect Coombs test may be performed. This test detects the presence of Rh antibodies in the mother's blood, indicating sensitization to Rh-positive blood cells. In certain cases, analysis of the amniotic fluid may be performed to measure fetal bilirubin levels. Elevated bilirubin levels can indicate hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn, a severe complication of Rh incompatibility. If Rh incompatibility is suspected or confirmed, fetal Rh typing can be done through invasive procedures like amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling, involving sampling fetal cells for Rh typing. Fetal blood count assesses fetal anemia severity in Rh incompatibility. Low red blood cell levels, decreased hemoglobin, hematocrit, and other anemia markers may be seen in the sample. The treatment of rhesus incompatibility aims to prevent sensitization in Rh-negative mothers and manage complications that may arise due to Rh alloimmunization in subsequent pregnancies. Rh-negative mothers who are at risk of Rh alloimmunization, such as during pregnancy, childbirth, miscarriage, or abortion, are routinely administered Rh immunoglobulin. Rh immunoglobulin contains antibodies against the Rh factor and works by binding to and neutralizing any Rh-positive fetal red blood cells that may have entered the maternal bloodstream, thus preventing sensitization. Rh immunoglobulin is typically given around the 28th week of pregnancy and within 72 hours after delivery or any other Rh incompatible event. Rh-negative mothers with Rh incompatibility history are closely monitored during pregnancy. This involves regular blood tests to detect Rh antibodies and assess fetal well-being using ultrasound and Doppler studies. If fetal anemia occurs due to Rh incompatibility, intrauterine blood transfusion may be performed. This procedure involves delivering compatible donor blood into the fetal circulation to alleviate anemia and prevent complications such as hydrops fetalis. In severe cases, early delivery or fetal therapies like intravascular transfusions may be necessary to manage complications. Infants born to Rh-sensitized mothers may require neonatal care, including phototherapy and blood transfusions, to manage complications resulting from Rh hemolytic disease, such as jaundice and anemia. Rh-negative women with a history of Rh incompatibility receive counseling before conception to discuss risks and management strategies for subsequent pregnancies. Healthcare providers and expectant parents are educated about Rh testing, Rh immunoglobulin administration, and early detection of Rh incompatibility complications. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.